There's a story about an old man who encounters a ghost of who he wants to be. There's a story about a man and a mountain. Like any sea, these mountains have a name. They are called Rockies. And upon the crest of the range, there's a trail that enables a person to walk across five states and through five separate ecological life zones. There's also a story about a specific point on the Pacific Trail. Follow the crest of the range. The thick growth of aspen and pine open onto a clearing. Much like being on a boat in the middle of a tumultuous sea, watching as the waves slowly calm. The moment when the world beyond the waves suddenly opens to all the possible worlds that are hiding within it. And things are finally clear. There's a place on Earth where the sky and the mountain, like the mountain and the sea, are one and the same. The mountain piercing the water of the sky and the sky flowing down on the mountain. The clarity of the sky prevents falling. The firmness of the earth prevents splitting. The strength of the spirit prevents its being used up. The fullness of the valley prevents its running dry. The growth of 10,000 things prevents their dying out. The Tao Te Ching. One day, my father took me to a specific trail on the mountain, and there we met an old man. His face was worn with tough wrinkles. He wore a hat that was tattered but functional. He was well layered, and his backpack was as big and perhaps as heavy as a deer. He told us that he'd been walking the trail since Montana, that he'd been walking for 3 years, and during those years, the only people he saw were the people he met on the trail. We were amazed by this man, his endurance, his loneliness, his withdrawal from the world, his persistence in walking, the fact that through walking he had become the mountain, that indeed there was really no way to separate him from the mountain because it had made its impression on him. He could have been the spirit of the mountain, he could have been a ghost, he could have been the breeze of the aspen as it brushed through the fur of a hare. This old man made me see that my father was utterly disconnected from the ground he was walking on. I noticed how he was walking ahead of me with a pace not at all suited for the terrain. Unlike the old man, my father's question about the cosmos, space, time, the universe, the one God of the present, and the many gods of ancient times, the galaxy and the peace of being in nothingness, were not rooted in his experience of walking here and now through the mountains. It seemed to me that these questions were in fact sending his mind into a spiral of confusion that gave him no insight into how to live a life worth leading. I too am occupied by the questions of my father, and like him, I wonder if the void is too great, if time is too vast, if humanity is too imperfect. And like him, I sometimes wonder if it all isn't remarkably futile, if enduring the persistence of fear and disappointment in our lives makes sense in the quest for an overall purpose. This story about a man who meets the ghost who he wants to be has already been told over and over. The man has disappeared. No traces are left. The bright moonlight is empty and shadowless, with all the 10,000 things growing on it. If anyone should ask the meaning of this, behold, the lilies of the field and their fresh, sweet scent. Did you? The preparation, the flour from the bread, the citrus from the fruit or the sweet. Take it away from the melon, make it rindy and hard, or the moisture from the clouds, make them lighter and transparent. If the blue was taken away from the sky, everything would be black. The particles from the light, take them away, make the objects of the earth disappear. Give back the fruit, the flowers, they came so unexpectedly. Why not give back the baskets and the cheese and all the meatloaf and the car? It could be given back to the driver and pointed in another direction. Give back the pine trees to the park, the parking lot to the birds, and the air to silence. Give back the field to the football players. All could begin again, and new it could all be given back. The glaciers.
water. The wind is not dry. It's not a person winter who decides there's no reason to fly. The air is not liquid. It's not a person ocean who decides there's no reason to breathe. If the light which you have spoken felt as light, would there really be any reason to see? If being such as you say in his assuming a state officer's form, the philosophy will manifest itself in the form of a state officer and preaching the dharma, the quantum of nature. If a person is to be saved by a herd of elk, then a herd of elk will appear to the person and lead him to the sunless side of the mountain. If a person is to be saved by a mountain lion, then a mountain lion will appear to the person and lead him across the river. If a person is to be saved by a bee, then a bee will appear to a person and lead him through the sun. If a person is to be saved by a person who understands the Tao, then a person who understands the Tao will appear to the person and teach him about numbers. If a person is to be saved by a junkyard dog, then a junkyard dog will appear to a person and lead him to a pot of gold. If a person is to be saved by a pilot, then a pilot will appear to a person and lead him through the rain. If a person looking for an object is to be saved by a shopkeeper, then a shopkeeper will appear to a person and lead him to a different object than the one he's looking for. If a person is to be saved by a person driving a truck, then a person driving a truck will appear to the person and push him off the road. If a person is to be saved by a person opening a window, then a person opening a window will appear to the person and lead him into the house. If a person is to be saved by a person helping another person jumpstart a car, then a person helping another person jumpstart a car will appear to the person and lead him through the electric charge. If a person is to be saved by a person walking with another person looking at a plane, then a person walking with another person looking at a plane will appear to the person and lead him into the future. If a person is to be saved by a person hitting another person who is the person being hit, then the person hitting another person who is the person being hit will appear to the person and lead him through the cave. If these people and then these people appear to a person, then all these people are here to lead a person home. If a person doesn't want to go home, then he will be led to the mountain and there he will disappear. If a person disappears on the way to the mountain, then another person will arrive at the mountain and will know that the mountain led this person into the glacier.